This video only talks about the important points related to target costing, value engineering, and Kaizen. Please note, it is not a replacement for the lecture. It is only that we are looking at the important points related to the topic. The learning objective for this topic are that we have to understand what is a target pricing and what is target costing, and how we can look at the pricing strategy of a company, particularly when you have a high competition. We will look at the pricing approaches. There are two important approaches we're going to talk about. First is your cost plus markup approach, and second is the target pricing approach. We would also look at under what circumstances company can use which pricing approach. Then we're going to look at some main cost management techniques like value engineering and Kaizen, and how they can help us in reducing the cost. Two focus points for the lecture. One is how target pricing is being done, and the second is how cost management can be done based upon target costing along with its supporting tool like value engineering and Kaizen. When setting a price, when I say price, we're looking at long-term price. So when setting a price, the company has to look into a lot of factors as to whether and how much consumers are going to pay, what is the competition in the market, or whether what kind of product they are going to offer, and all those things. But the most important thing which they have to consider is, are they price taker or a price setter? Price setter or price taker, because this is one of the important consideration in deciding what kind of a pricing strategy you're going to adopt. We look at Adidas and Payless Shoes. Adidas is a well-known company, whereas Payless Shoes is a no-brand company. So which one is a price setter or a price taker? If you look at Adidas, the shoes they offer, they are a differentiated products. They are unique product and they provide unique features to the customers. So if you are offering a differentiated product, then you tend to become a price setter. Price setter simply means that you have better control on what kind of prices you're going to charge to the customers. But if you are a generic shoe seller, right? Generic shoe seller means that there's no particular brand, there is no uniqueness of your product. If the product you're offering is not unique, in that case, you tend to become a price taker. For example, shoes. If everybody is selling a pair of shoes, you're going to charge what the market is offering. So Payless Shoes, selling a generic shoes with no unique features, tend to become a price taker. And if you are a price taker, then you are more inclined to use target pricing approach. Let's take another example. There are two burgers. One is McDonald's burger, and then it is a burger which is sold by any roadside restaurant. Okay, so we would like to pay a premium for a McDonald's burger, and we will try to pay lesser for a generic burger, right? So in this case, McDonald's would have more control on what kind of pricing it is setting for the burger, whereas a generic burger seller is more of a price taker, because, you know, if the product is not unique and there is a high competition in the market, everybody is selling the same product. So are you finally a price taker or price setter? We would look at these features, uniqueness, level of competition, and based upon that, you're going to determine our pricing strategy, a pricing approach. So how would we are going to decide which pricing strategy we're going to adopt? That will depend on price setter or a price taker. If you are a price setter, you have better control on the prices. You are offering a unique or differentiated product. In that case, have the luxury of using cost plus pricing approach. But in case you are in a highly competitive market, you are not offering any unique product, you are offering a generic product, you become a price taker, and hence you are more inclined to use target pricing approach. Finding your selling price in cost plus pricing approach is simple. You look at your full cost. Full cost includes your fixed as well as variable cost. You add your desired profit. Desired profit is given to you by the management. And that's it. You got your selling price. For target pricing approach, we go reverse. We look at our selling price first. And selling price, we are not setting the selling price. The selling price is given to us by the market. Why? Because we are selling a generic product. We are not selling a differentiated product. We are not selling a unique product. And hence, we don't have the luxury of charging higher than what market is offering. So we have to use and we have to adopt the same selling price which is prevalent in the market. Remember, it's a highly competitive market. So selling price, so we take the selling price which is existing in the market and then we reduce our desired profit, which is again given to us and it remains same as what we have charged in cost plus pricing approach. And then we look at the cost. So once you have figured out your target cost, what next? So what we do is, once you have this figure of target cost means that if you want to achieve the desired profit, remember you don't have a control on the selling price. So if you want to achieve your desired profit, the only thing which you can do is manage your cost. If your actual cost or if your cost at present are higher than your target cost, you must do cost cutting exercise immediately to get the desired profit. So for cost cutting and for cost management, we are going to look at the combination of three tools: target costing, value engineering. And the central issue of target costing is not what our cost actually is. No. The central issue of target costing is what should be the cost of the product. Let's go a bit deeper into the target cost and see what is the process which is underlying the whole setting of target cost. So this is a detailed description of what goes behind the target cost area. So you start with your market research, you have a look on the market, you have a look on the customer, you look at the features which you're going to provide, you look at how much value these features are for the customers, and based upon that, you find out what is the price prevalent in the market, you deduct your profit, that gives you your target cost. This is a graphical representation of how target costing is used in Japan and how your cost plus pricing approach is used in US. You can see that once you have find out your target costing, you use value engineering, designing, and you look at your value chain to ensure that you meet your target cost, and then you start with your manufacturing. Once you have your target cost ready, then you look at what is my current cost or what is my existing cost, or is my existing cost higher than my target cost? If your existing cost is higher than your target cost, then you must undertake value engineering. Why you have to do value engineering? You have to use value engineering to redesign the product in such a way that the cost can be reduced. And please note, value engineering is done before actual starting of the production. And after value engineering, then you start manufacturing. And once you start manufacturing, the next step is Kaizen. Kaizen is a continuous improvement in the product. Value engineering simply means if you're not able to achieve your target cost, then you have to go back and redesign your product. Redesign your product, and you have to keep redesigning your product till the time you are not able to achieve your target cost. And when you are redesigning your product, you have to ensure that you don't compromise with the functionality or the features of the product. So let's talk about another cost management tool by Japanese manufacturing system, that is Kaizen. Kaizen is a continuous improvement in your production process. Please note, value engineering is done before you start your manufacturing, because redesigning and further, you know, changing in the functionality of the product, design, features, and all those things are possible only before starting off your manufacturing process. Once you have started your manufacturing process, then you cannot go back and redesign because production is already started. In that case, once your production has started, you would look at step by step gradual improvement. So the continuous improvement which is happening in the production process to reduce your cost is called as Kaizen. For ensuring there is a continuous improvement happening over the manufacturing cycle, we would look at improvising on our manufacturing systems, our processes. We try and focus on more productivity, and we would look at what kind of enhancement we can do in our manufacturing process so that we can reduce the cost. So ultimately, it boils down to one simple question. Do you want to maintain cost leadership? Do you want to offer a high quality product with a low price without compromising on design, features, or functionality of the product? Or do you just want to survive a highly competitive market but still want to attain profitability? In that case, target pricing is the right approach and target costing is the way to go forward. Because with target costing, you'll not only be able to achieve the desired profitability, but you're also able to reduce your cost, increase your satisfaction, because customers are going to love your product. You are selling your product at a lower price, whereas also ensuring that the same functionality is there, and improvising on the overall quality of the product. That's it for target costing, value engineering, and Kaizen. Please attempt numerical questions for further details. Thank you.